This is Sports Matters with Jerry Colin.
Jerry Colin.
It's so retro.
We cover all the biggest sports on the planet. MMA, boxing, snooker, football, darts. You name it and we cover it. Check out all the latest interviews with Jerry and the Stairs weekly on Sports Matters.
So welcome to Sports Matters with me, Jerry Colin. I'm joined simply by one of the greatest air players of our time, Mr. Steve Beaton. Steve, how's things with you, my friend?
Oh, fine, thanks. Not too bad at all.
That's good. And you're still making a big impact when it comes to darts. You've been around for so many years and you're still there.
Yeah, too long, some people say.
Not at all.
No, yeah, but oh, probably, I don't know, 30-odd years now. Yeah, I'm still loving the game. So, you know, as long as I'm competing and keeping up with the rest of them, I'll keep going.
That's all that matters. And, of course, you're throwing very well. Like, just, like, you know, all the kind of off-TV tournaments as well, you're doing quite well. You're always taking the big scalps and, you know, you're always thereabouts. Tell us, how did it start for you first there, Steve?
Just as a bit of fun, really. I mean, at school, I never thought I'd be a dart player or anything. You know, just it was one of those things that you used to meet at a pub before we went up the town. So it was either have a game of pool or darts or something like that. And I just happened to be good at darts. It went on from there, really. Started playing for my county, then for England. And then I just went up the ladder, really. But no, originally, I never thought I was going to be a dart player when I was a kid.
So, and like you've achieved so much over the years, but like you made your world championship debut in 1992. Like, what did it feel like first of all to qualify for your first world championships? Because like no doubt all the practice, you know, it kind of paid off to get that first big break.
Yeah, I mean it was great. Cause, I mean I used to watch it like when I was a kid, and I've always loved darts, and I used to watch Eric and Louie and that lot battling it out, and you know my dream was to get up there and play in the world championship. And the first year, obviously, I didn't do too good in the first year, but 93 I probably should have won it that year. Actually, I got to the semis, lost to Alan Warner, but yeah, that was probably the best chance, really, was 93 to actually win it.
Yeah, and I know Alan beat you in the semis, but of course, I think 93 was the year that you became a full-time professional, where you made the kind of the switch to the full-time circuit. Like, you won the Women's World Masters in 93. That's a prestigious tournament. Like, some people say, like obviously these days, the Women's World Masters, it's not as strong as it was back in, like, the 90s era. But what was it like winning that Women's World Masters, because it's such a prestigious tournament?
Well, yeah, like you say, it was different back then. I mean, we used to have to qualify all the way through it. And then when you got down to London to start the tournament, there was, like, 100 odd people. Now it's a bit seeded. I think the top 16 go into the last 32. But yeah, we had to play all the way from scratch in groups, and yeah, you know, that was a good one to win. You know, with all the best in the world there. It's that was obviously the first big major one I won.
Definitely, and like you've won numerous tournaments. Like, tell us about that world title, because dreams do come true if you work hard. Like the players you beat en route to winning that was incredible. Like the likes of Cole Stump, John Peart, Martin Adams, Andy Foran. And then, of course, Richie Burnett. What was it like to clinch that first world title?
Brilliant. You know, I mean, it was funny. People say, do you remember it? You know, all you do is just put your head down. You're just trying to win it. You know, it weren't until the bloke said, game shot, and you've won. You know, I didn't realise that I'd actually won it. You know, it's hard to take the focus off. You know, you've got to keep concentrating. It's so easy for your mind to wander and look into the crowd and that lot. But it was just keeping focus. And, yeah, it's brilliant. You know, dream come true.
It's really been around so long. Like, you know, I remember, like, you know, even when your darts came out first, like, back then, obviously, like, we have so many websites and so many, you know, ways of buying darts, but back then, like, they were like gold dust. You know, I still have your old original darts at home, and like, they're going to be worth a lot of money in another couple of years. But for you, like, do you think the game's changed much, Steve? Obviously, there's a lot more, you know, TV, and of course, Sky have done a great job, you know, with the PDC and stuff, but it's a different game, do you think?
Oh yeah, definitely. Now it's. I mean, when I won it in '96, the money wasn't really in it. You know, it was sort of dying on its feet. We were struggling like for TV and things, and then obviously Barry coming in, like I think it was 2000, 2002, and you know, just changed the whole sport around. You know, I mean, it's the second watch sport to football now. It's unbelievable, really. And the crowds were getting like at the Premier Leagues and things like that. You know, you'd never dream of 6,000 or 7,000 people just going to watch a darts match. You know, so yeah. It's you know, it's absolutely brilliant the way it's got now, and especially for the youth now. I mean, it's what a perfect opportunity for the. For the young lads now to come through, and you know, like Michael Van Gerwen's done, you know, they can do the same.
Of course, and like, there's obviously a good living to be made. Like, if I was to ask you, obviously, you know, like, you know, you won the World Championship in '96, and of course, the Women's World Masters. Like, would it be fair to say you're a better player now than you were back because the standard's gone a tiny bit higher, or is it just, you know, hard to say?
I probably am playing better. It's funny, really, because like then, you know, your averages and that lot were slightly lower. I mean, obviously the boards have improved now, the wires and things
bigger,
like
bigger
that.
Troubles, yeah.
Yeah, I mean, it is slightly better, but you know, the averages now. I mean, like Phil's very, you know, never under 100 average all the time. Same with Michael.
Yeah.
You know, the averages now are ridiculous. You know, it used to be in the 90s, now it's in the 100s. So,
yeah.
You know, yes, definitely improved and. It's good, you know, it's good for the sport.
Of course, and for the fans, like you know, I was talking to John Lowe not so long ago, and John was saying, like, you know, like, his average back in, you know, the 80s and 90s wasn't far off the averages now. So, like, you know, it's just obviously because the standard, like, we're seeing more of the higher standard these days. Like, you know, in the 90s, you'd see the high standard anyway. It was the likes of yourself and a couple of the bigger lads that would always have that good average. But I think these days now, like, their players really have to have that average of kind of, like, you know, 94+. To have a really good, decent game. And, like, if you can hit the 100 mark then, which a lot of you are doing, it just makes that game a bit better, you know? But it's great to see it, and it's great to see how far the game's come. Like, if I was to ask you...
I was going to say, like, when I actually won the World Championship, I think I was averaging 96 all the way through it. So
yeah, you're right.
You're right. I mean, you've got to be up in them sort of averages to win it. I mean, now you might have to be 100 something, but, you know, yeah, definitely you need a high average.
Big averages. And, like... Can you remember, Steve, the first time you hit your first ever nine darter? It's a question I love asking dare players. Was it a Ross Lowe by any chance?
It was a Ross Lowe, yes.
I was just double-checking because someone said it to me. I was actually there, and I actually seen the game. But someone said to me it was your first nine darter. But I was like,
It was in the tournament, yeah. I mean, obviously, I didn't have a practice ball, but it was the first in the tournament. And I think the year before, they actually had a car.
Yeah,
and
they did.
For a nine darter.
They did. I remember saying that. It was the Crosby Cedars.
That's right.
BBC Irish Masters in Ross Lare. Great tournament when it lasted for them 3-4 years. But someone said it to me. They're like, I actually seen the nine darter. I was watching it. I was waiting for an autograph, obviously, and you hit the nine darter. And someone said, oh, that's Steve's first nine darter. And maybe I was a bit young, but I was like, no, he's probably hit one before, like, in tournament. But there you go. You just answered the question for me.
Yeah, no, that was the first one in the tournament. Yeah, obviously you hit them now, like in exhibitions and things like that, and practicing. But yeah, I think they did a whip round for me. I think they got me a few hundred euros.
Yeah, I don't remember that. I remember because I remember getting the autograph straight after it. It was literally. I've seen 2 9 darters. I've seen Mark Walsh hit one in Ireland, funny enough, in Clarny, and I've seen you hit one as well. So it's not every day you get to see a nine darter in front of you, like. So I'm grateful and delighted at the same time. You enjoy the exhibitions, obviously. You're still doing a lot of exhibitions around the place. I've actually played you in Cork, but is this something you quite enjoy because you can kind of relax that bit more?
Yeah, I mean, because you get to meet people. You know, it's a great sport, and that's why I probably love darts, because, you know, you get to meet different people all the time. You know, I've been out in Holland yesterday, well, Friday.
Yeah.
Same again, you know, you meet different people again. It's a good mix of sport, you know. People can go out, have a bit of a laugh, have a drink, enjoy themselves, you know, and have a game of darts. So, you know, I think that's a great side of it.
Of course. And of course, Steve, what's the plan for the next 12 months? Like, you're playing quite well, as I said. You're, you know, the consistency is there because you've always stayed in that top 32. You're currently ranked at number 25. You're kind of going up the rankings again, which is great to see, because, well, you know, we don't want you to go off the scene. Like, you're, like, another 20 years, really, you're still going to be there. But, like, obviously, are you going to aim for, like, the Premier League and you're hoping to, you know, get a good run in the World Championships, which you're well capable of doing, you know?
Yeah, I mean, obviously, I'm out next in October for the Grand Prix. I'm looking forward to that one. But, you know, as long as I can keep qualifying for tournaments, that's the main thing, you know. And I wouldn't want to play in the Premier League unless I'd actually done something
course.
You know, like got to the final or something, or even win a big tournament. You know, I wouldn't just want to get an invite into it. I'd rather earn it through merit, really.
Do it the right way, yeah.
But, you know, I've been playing, you know, I've always been in the top 32, and I think to the day I stay, you know, I'll go out of 32, you know, I'll just keep going. But, yeah, you know, I love darts, and, you know, I think it's a great sport.
It definitely is. Like, well, I think, like, Grand Prix is coming up soon in Dublin. We're looking forward to that one. The Dublin's there. And, of course, the World Championships, it's prestigious, you know, it's the best thing on TV for any man or even a lady that likes darts. We're looking forward to it. Steve, we wish you the best of luck for the Grand Prix and, of course, the rest of the tournaments throughout the year. We know that, you know, you can win the tournament, no problem. It's only a matter of time before you win that next major again, fingers crossed. So listen, thank you for taking the time to speak to us. It means a lot.
Oh, no problem. And hopefully it might be the Grand Prix that I win.
I hope so. We're going to be there. And I don't see why not. You're well able. You're well able, Steve. So thank you very much. It means a lot. And I'll chat to you in Dublin very soon.
Okay. Thanks a lot.